meters.
Hello, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson, along with Jay Rand, our analyst and expert commentator for our ski jumping coverage here at Malapolye. Jay, from out of the West comes an American from Winter Park, Colorado, named Kerry Lynch, who is a definite contender for a medal.
That's right. Kerry has great possibilities here, especially if he can do well in the jumping portion. If he can stay within 3 to 5 points of Tom Sandberg of Norway, I think he's in a good position for a gold medal.
Now, this is a back-to-back competition. From one day right into the next, the first day is explosive power. The next day, you use everything you've got in your body in endurance.
That's right. You have to be out there for 40 to 45 minutes in a grueling cross-country race, which requires endurance. The jumping portion requires explosive power. You must move quickly into the air, so it's completely two opposite motions.
And we begin early in the first round with a piece of bad news for the American team. Pat Ahern of Breckenridge, Colorado, had this jump, 89 meters for 112.3 points. He loses it because the jury, after a meeting, decided to cancel it and restart. Start him lower because they were overjumping the hill. They have moved the jumpers down the in-run one gate. That will slow them down some and will shorten the distances they're jumping, keep them off of that transition, and eliminate the possibility of severe injury. Tom Sandberg of Norway flies pretty well, 92.2 points for Sandberg. This is Kerry Lynch of the United States waiting to jump. Let's meet Kerry Lynch.
Whenever he can, Kerry Lynch returns home to the rangelands of western Colorado like a thirsty nomad to a waterhole. Lynch has packed a lifetime of living into 26 years. Divorced and the father of a four-year-old daughter, he spends a lot of time doing chores at his girlfriend's ranch. Lynch's specialty, the Nordic combined event, is a grueling hybrid of ski jumping and cross-country racing. Lynch finished 18th at the Lake Placid Olympics, but figures he has a good shot at a medal this time around in the sport whose variety is the spice of his life.
I ski combined because I don't like doing one thing. I like doing other things. I like ski jumping and I like cross country both. In the cross country in the 15 kilometer race, the biggest fight is to push yourself until you can overcome the pain barrier. When you leave the takeoff on the jump hill, have you ever been on a roller coaster and gone down and, you know, real fast, and your stomach kind of leaves you for a minute? That's what it feels like. This sport requires a lot of time and away from home. Your personal life has everything to do with how you're going to perform. You have to be happy. You have to enjoy what you're doing. You have to live in an atmosphere that you're comfortable and living with.
Part of the comfortable atmosphere is the Lynch Mob, a country and western band featuring Kerry's father, an uncle, a brother, and Kerry himself on drums. The best Nordic combined skier in the United States, well-traveled Kerry Lynch, is still just a country boy.
Well, let's see if that picking and singing will help him a little bit now as he stands at the top of the in run for his first round jump in the Nordic combined. The best two out of three apply in the jumping competition. He needs one, Jay Rand, because he's a great cross-country man. We know that he's going to ski that 15 kilometers as good as anybody in the world, but this is his weakness if he has one.
Yes, he has to stay within a few points of Tom Sandberg. This is an important jump for him. However, as you stated, combined jumpers do get the best two out of three, so they can afford to have one that's not up to par.
All right, Lynch is now ready to go.
This is the one that Kerry's been waiting for and training for years. It's in a nice in-run position. Takeoff looked good, timing was right, overski's nice, and it looks like a nice jump all the way around.
Just short of the transition area in the hill, which is marked by the red, and it's 80 meters. 80 meters for Kerry Lynch, 95.9 points. A look at it now in slow motion.
Now, Kerry's in a low position, as he should be. He's got a lot of forward angle on the lower part of his leg, and there you see him really compressing into the takeoff. The air entry is good. He's extended over the skis. He brought his hands out a little bit there, but I don't think that affected the judges' scores.
Well, in the first effort, he is just a couple of points ahead of Tom Sandberg.